this is the first time I've been able to see the 4000 and the new 200 megahertz antenna in action.
That is like a 10, 12 foot vertical displacement. That is incredible.
I've collected a lot of radar data at this particular site, so I'm very familiar with the subsurface conditions. And this is by far the best imaging I've ever been able to obtain in terms of characterizing the buried sinkhole features.
That's great penetration. I mean, that probably is close to twice of what we got with the 270.
Yeah.
And a lot clearer.
There's a lot of adjustments you can do on the fly. I'm able to really go through and fine-tune it so I can bring out features that we had not been able to go through an image.
It's a full suite of new capabilities that we haven't seen before. A dipping reflector set and increase in amplitude of depth penetration. That's perfect. One thing that I noticed with the Hyperscan is that we can really increase our speed of travel and data collection.
I was impressed with the interface, so it'll be something that'll be fairly easy for us guys to use. I like the ability to go through and make adjustments in terms of how the data is being imaged relatively quickly and in the field. So we're going to be able to do a better job in terms of our in-field data interpretation than we could in the past.
Yeah, you can really see the structure there. That's, again, textbook if you want to teach people on how to look at GPR profiles.
So I think it'll be a really important piece of equipment to add to our arsenal.
This just seems to be a whole new generation of technology that's really going to open up a lot of opportunities that weren't there before.